whatever Cole was thinking putting this second last is just horrible, really. And apologies even to any client that I have done this to and put it towards the end of the session. I feel it. So we are back again. It is 5:30 to 6 in the morning. We're out in Woodstown Beach, just watching the sunrise up over here. She's back there getting some pictures and stuff. We done this last week and it was just such a nice way to get up on the weekend. It's not, I suppose, in terms of time frames, not hugely different than my normal routine in terms of getting up early. It's about an hour and a half earlier, but tell you what, it's a lot easier to get up, to come out, sit and relax and watch that, than it is to get up and jump on a bike for 20 minutes. I can guarantee you that. So we're going to chillax, get some content for the gram. Is that right? And then we're going to stop on the way home and get a munch. Was the sunrise done and dusted? Lovely morning. How did you find it? But so ticked off, nice early start. It is 7:30. We've been awake. What time did you get up to put your makeup on? To go watch the sunrise? Yeah. But now it's the most apparent.
It's the most apparent.
So, the most important part of the morning, the deli food. Jam buns, sausage rolls, wedges. So, we're going to go in, get that. I'm actually going to train really early today, just get it done and out of the way. But I'm training, you're not allowed to train. We're going to bring it through legs, so we're going to get this food in. And then we will get straight out to the sheds. So we are into make the intro workouts and the pre-workouts now. So pre-workout of choice, we already made that up here. We have got our JP Stim. They changed the formula some minute. There's all lumpy bits and stuff in it, but you know, we move. We've got our creatine, EAAs, glutamine, and then we've got our bag of carbs as well. So at the minute we have 70 grams of carbs intra workout. I actually split it at the minute. I do 20 grams of carbs with my pre-workout, with the actual pre-workout drink, wherever it is, there we go. And then I use 50 grams of carbs then intra workout, just sits a little bit better in my stomach. 5 grams creatine, 5 grams glutamine, and then 15 grams EAAs. It's not the best flavour EAAs, it's the orange JP EAA, bit of a taste to it, but again, I think the JP is a bit more known for, you know, the quality and the dosing of it rather than the taste of it. So we are going to jump into the session now. We're going to go down, warm up the legs, bring you through the session, talk you through how we set up each exercise, and then we'll bring you through the rest of the day. Why not? Ooh, so it's absolutely freezing down here. Put on that new merch. So new RDF oversized crew necks. Embroidered stitching 124. Worry about it. So we're just getting everything set up. As you can see, we gave HQ a little paint job, a bit of a renovation. We got some lights, nice walls painted, nice grey. Had just been putting it off, just didn't want to do it. So after much feedback from one particular person, we went ahead and got it done. So we're going to get into the session. Just going to warm up for a minute. Radiator is heating up. Flying solo today, so it will be just myself. Rachel has been sick all week, so Meg has pulled her training until she gets 1 or 2 days worth of rest day food back into her, just to get energy levels back up. When we're coming back from any kind of illness, any kind of sickness, been run down and stuff, you don't want to just jump back into the deep end. You're kind of easing back in, start to get your routine back in order, and then start to progress back into the training. But the training is the last thing that is really added in. So we're going to manage this, we're going to work it out. We'll set the camera up, I'll talk you through my setup. A little bit of a different leg session today. Squats have been taken out, so we have got leg extension, lion hamstring curl, split squat, we've got a single leg, dumbbell RDL, and hip thrust. Not in those, not in that order, but those are the exercises we're working with. So we're going to play around with that today. We're only doing one set of everything, keeping it between 10 to 12 reps. So I'm going to go in, get warmed up. So first exercise up, we have got a single leg extension. So for the leg extension, we're using one of the cuffs. We've got the 1MR cuffs. Any of the cuffs off Amazon and stuff will work here. We've obviously got the little pulley here, but again, we're not really using a lot of weight on it. And what we've got is we've got two bands here, and the bands are for the top part of the movement. Okay, so for the contraction at the top, we're trying to get as much out of it as possible. So trying to overload that kind of top third of the actual exercise itself. Single leg, again, just because the seat that we have, it's a little bit easier to do a single leg. So we've got the bench kind of angled up. Again, if you're doing it from home with bands and stuff, if you don't have a cuff, you can literally just hook that in and around the front of the ankle there. If you're sitting on like a chair or anything, you could even get like a little book or a wedge, like the yoga wedges that you can get for like 3 or 4 quid. Pop that underneath, just to, again, you want to kind of raise that knee up so that the leg is kind of off the ground, so that when you're coming up, you've got the tension through here by being able to just flex solely through that knee. So we're going to get into the actual working set of it now. As I said, we're only doing one set on each exercise. So we'll do one set on each leg, again, 10 to 12 kind of reps on it. Nothing special, so we're just kind of sliding that in. That sits just at the top of the ankle, so I like to put it just a little bit above the ankle. Oh, made it fell. And then coming out. So as you can see, my knee sitting right on the edge of the bench, just kind of pulling myself down into the chair, fully stretch and squeeze at the top. So again, get a full stretch at the bottom, up to the top, big squeeze, hold. And we're kind of holding at the top for that 1-2. So perfect, right, so we are in on our lion hamstring curl. Equipment needed, bench, foam roller, daisy chain, cuffs, and seated row machine, bands, you name it. We're actually going climbing a mountain at this stage. But again, we're not giving up. You know, we've got equipment to use and we're going to make the most out of it. So the idea of the foam roller is that the foam roller sits in on the hips. It allows you to push the hips down into it, contracting the glutes as we're pulling up, and allowing the hamstrings to take the weight.
What you'll see a lot of the time is, without anything like the foam roller or anything, you're lying down on the bench here, the hips tend to shoot up to get the weight to come up to the top. What you're actually doing there is you're not actually using the hamstrings to pull the weight up. You've just popped the hips up, hips are taking the weight, and then the weight has actually dropped off the hamstrings. So, foam roller, in on the bench, hips down onto the foam roller, contracting the glutes, and then we're just kind of dragging the heels up while the glutes are contracted to get the load in on the hamstring as much as possible. So we're going to get this set up, give you a look at the working set in action, and then we will keep moving through the session. So working set in 3, 2, 1. Okay, so let's talk hip thrusting. King of building a bum. Again, different kind of setups, different variations of it, but in terms of actually loading the glutes in a shortened and lengthened position, it's an absolute must. I think neglected, especially from a male perspective, neglected a lot. But, you know, just a reminder, females like a fella that can fill out a pair of jeans just as much as a fella likes a girl to fill out a pair of jeans. So, get your hip thrusts in, make sure they're in your program. I'm going to talk you through the actual setup of it now so that you have no excuses. With the actual stool, foam roller, stand leg, I think that's in one of the previous videos we showed you. This is again just to stop the stool from smashing underneath us. With the actual setup then, feet going to be shoulder width apart, and as we're kind of pushing up, slightly pushing the knees out. Again, we're really just trying to load the glutes here through this whole movement. Kuba has shortened the actual range of motion that I'm doing at the minute as well. So I'll only be doing about a half range of motion of a full hip thrust. When we're driving up, I like to have my shoulder blades just on the stool. Just it gives me support when I kind of tilt up, that the my full upper back is there, and when I'm kind of sitting in it, it's just underneath the shoulder blades here. Chin tucked in. This for me just keeps the spine neutral as I'm driving up, just allowing the bum to take the full weight. And then when I'm driving up, again, it's from here to here. So that's all I'm going to be doing today, is just loading from there to there. So we're going to get some weight on it. We're going into our working set here now, and we will give you a little look at it in action. So we are nearly there. Second last exercise. We have got a Bulgarian split squat. So, like, whatever Kuba was thinking of putting this second last in, just horrible, really. And apologies even to any client that I have done this to and put it towards the end of the session. I feel your pain. So I'm using just the bar here to add a little bit of stability to the actual exercise itself. So the dumbbell itself, I am going to catch that on the side that my leg is elevated, and then I'm going to kind of use this as a little bit of a crutch for all the world, just to kind of help stabilize myself as I'm going through the exercise. Again, just trying to focus on loading the exercise as much as possible. Trying to get as much weight onto the standing leg as we can. So before we actually get through and jump in with the weight, just to give you a little look at the setup. So again, as I said, just using this as a bit of stability, stepping out, going to pop that leg up behind, and again, dumbbell is going to be here. Just going to drop down into it. Try to keep the torso nice and tall. and then we're just going to drive up out of it. So again, just dropping down, driving up. But if you see, I'm giving myself quite a nice gap in between, so I'm taking quite a big step out with that front leg. Again, it's just going to help, it actually helps from a stability point of view to have that kind of big step there. So again, loading, squeezing nice and tight, trim the stomach, bracing nice and hard, dropping down, and then a big drive up to the top. So again, we're getting to our working set. Give you a little look at how it goes. Again, apologize to any client that I have done this in the past. I feel a bit. So, absolutely messed up with the hands, and it was popping through the leg. So, dumbbell in the leg that's going to be on the floor, hand on the thing down the leg behind. But yeah, again, sincere apologies, any clients. So with our setup here, again, I'm going to use the squat stand just as a bit of support and to provide, I can't even speak, and to provide a bit of stability through the movement. So just kind of using it to stabilize, not needing to help my kind of drive through it or anything, just to kind of stabilize with it. This foot, so the leg that I'm not loading, I'm going to put slightly back and I'm going to shift all the way onto this standing leg. From here then, I'm going to have the dumbbell in the hand of the leg I'm loading. So I'll be like this. And again, it's just pushing the hip back, hip back, hip back, getting it to the point where your hip is fully back, your back is still nice and straight, so we've not kind of arched or rounded through the back. And then we're going to drive hips back up through, loading up as much as we can through the top range, and again, just nice and steady on it, nice and slow on it, not really kind of flying through the motion, and just trying to mimic every bit of it that we can. And that would be pretty much the session wrapped up then. So, gonna get into this, get it ticked off, because I'm absolutely better. Yeah, that's not on me. Don't tell you where this is going now. There we go. Oh, we're getting it. So, leg back, roll up, back. So last thing then, for calves, we just get track sends and cover them. I mean, simple as. I can't see.
Save your glasses.
So we didn't get anything after training yesterday, but we have decided to take rest day steps on an adventure. So as you can see, making the most of the sun, living so close to this and getting steps in. So we are going to wrap it up here. We're going to bring you through legs next, and hopefully then we are going to be very, very close to the gym, so we'll be back open.